on, then this is the bill for you. If you want to see about 40% of the construction jobs gone, then this is the bill for you. Because you create unemployment, you create homelessness, and you create blight. If that's what you'd like, then you should vote for this bill. Members, I would ask for a no vote because in this budget year, we're looking at ways that we're able to get money. And again, I point out that there are a couple of proposals. I passed one out in front of you where you can get some of the money. One of the things I hope you'll look at as well in the pictorial I passed out is look at the before and after pictures that were of the agencies around your district. Look at that land before and after redevelopment and ask yourself, how much tax money would the school get from the blighted piece of property that was converted? Not a dime. So here you're not going to get any money. You're not going to get anything to the school. You're not going to get any jobs. You're not going to get anything of positive value. And more important, by the time you get through, you will not get one dime in this budget year. This is poor policy. It's poorly thought out. There are a number of things that would work better. I ask for your no vote.
Senator Padilla.
Always tough to follow Senator Wright. And I won't attempt other than to say ditto, but Senator Wright, I actually have something to add to what you said. Colleagues, this is an issue that I know has been, has been difficult for me since it was first proposed back in January. So I feel compelled to state for the record and for the public my thoughts. I approach the discussion about redevelopment through the lens of equity. Now, there's already been one senator who has raised their mic today and suggested that with this bill, we're sort of reinstating the free market system. And if we were to leave economic development, economic growth, job creation, and opportunity simply to market forces, we would not have an equitable distribution of that opportunity and development throughout the state. And in all likelihood, we would not see it in the most needy parts of the state, as evidenced by the appearance of blight over time, which has led to the criteria and the very fiscal tools of tax increment financing that is at the very core of redevelopment. Most of you, if not all of you, have visited Los Angeles in the past, so you're familiar with the city and the region. I represent the San Fernando Valley. But for redevelopment, you'd see still probably tremendous growth in downtown Los Angeles. You'd probably still continue to see a lot of economic activity on the west side of Los Angeles. But getting comparable growth from an economic standpoint, an infrastructure standpoint, an affordable housing standpoint in many parts of my district are nearly impossible without tools like redevelopment. And like each and every member of this body, I believe that my constituents deserve equal opportunity as everybody else, equal access as everybody else. To me, that's what redevelopment represents. Has redevelopment on a statewide basis been perfect in the past? No. Is there room for improvement, reform, and fixes? Yes. And we must do those. But to me, to eliminate redevelopment or begin the fixing process by starting with elimination is not the way to go. A couple presidents ago, we heard mend it, don't end it as a catchphrase to very challenging policy issues. So when it comes to redevelopment in California, I'd say mend it, don't end it. Now, specifically to the proposal before us about this, we're going to undo redevelopment, as you know, but rebuild it through this voluntary, contribution to the state and these new rules of the game that helps keep money flowing through schools. One of the specific questions I've asked, and we're getting the answer to, is on an agency-by-agency basis, it's a question mark. Which entities are in a fiscal position to be able to first and foremost pay their debt financing obligations, and based on how much money is left, can they even fulfill the pass-through to school dollar amount. In some cases, yes. In some cases, no. And I don't know how many redevelopment agencies fall into which column. And maybe you can fulfill that debt obligation and have a nickel left, which isn't a whole heck of a lot, to actually do the job of redevelopment and economic development. So I think there's a little bit more homework that needs to be done here. I've been told, well, there's an appeal process for people who may be in that situation. But I think as we have discussed both publicly and privately in the last several months, that those arbiters, those referees in that appeal process haven't shown themselves to be the most neutral when it comes to what they think of redevelopment as a tool in redevelopment agencies as we know them. So there's got to be a fairer way. There's got to be a better way. And I know I've shared this with Senator Steinberg, as have others, and I'm told that we're working on a better way to do it, where you factor in the debt financing costs off the top, and of what's left, maybe there's a guaranteed minimum percentage for redevelopment agencies who choose to play ball, who choose to participate, to be able to continue to exist and go about their work. But I think as we stand here today, forget Ledge Council format language in front of me, even some bullet points that could outline how we do that. So as of 1:57 p.m. on today, June 15th, I don't feel comfortable supporting what's directly in front of us, but would happily participate as constructively as I can in the redevelopment 2.0. Thank you.
Senator LaMalfa.
Thank you, Mr. President. I rise in opposition for several reasons. First, we talk about how we want to check in with the voters and have them have their say. Well, once again, we have a recent example here with Proposition 22 just last November, where we had the legislative check-in with the voters on this issue of stealing money from local governments and specifically in the redevelopment area. Now, I certainly got plenty of heartburn with things that go on with redevelopment in California, with interpretation of blight, with eminent domain usage, misusage, abuse, and even how some of the dollars are being appropriated for things that really don't have much to do with economic development or increase in values or what have you that would cause economic activity in these jurisdictions. But a couple of the nuggets that come in here in this bill, particularly that make it a problem, is that we have a carve-out in here that further affirms collective bargaining. How does that even fit into this discussion? As well, we have a budget bypass tool in that Prop 98 funding would be usurped by having additional funding for schools that go around the process that we would normally have, going above Prop 98 obligations without really having the full vote and work of this body here. So we're putting yet another guarantee on top of Prop 98 with this measure, a budget-busting ploy. So if we're going to do something to fix, amend, whatever in the area of redevelopment, this bill ain't it. So as much as I'd like to see some reform in these areas, this isn't the one. So I urge your no vote.
Further debate or discussion? Further debate or discussion? Senator Steinberg.
Thank you very much, Mr. President. I know that this has been a difficult issue for members, continues to be a difficult issue for members, and there are some clarifications that I want to make here this afternoon that speak to my commitment as your leader to bring forth legislation to clarify, you might say, fix some of the issues that my members on both sides of the aisle have expressed to me. Before I do that, though, let me state a couple of things about the merits. Remember, members, this is a two-bill package. If the governor were to sign this bill, the elimination bill, and not sign the subsequent bill, which recreates redevelopment, the first bill, this bill, will not go into effect. So elimination is not a risk standing alone. You have to read the two bills together. Now, I heard my respected colleague, Senator Wright, talk about their money, their money. And every time I hear that, it makes me pause, and I hope it makes you pause, to ask the question, whose money are we talking about? It's not their money. It's not our money. It's not the state's money. It's not the city's money. It's the public's money. And as a legislature here, we have an obligation to set priorities. And Governor Brown has put forward priorities. And when you look at the two-bill package, what we've essentially said here, to simplify it, is that redevelopment should in fact continue, but it will have fewer resources than it has today. Why is that? Because this legislature, I think, believes, or the majority believes, that given the fiscal constraints that we have here, that we ought to keep redevelopment, but that $1 billion, let's call it, that we're reducing it by, that we would rather do that than cut another $1 billion of higher education. We'd rather do this than cut another $1 billion to the poor and the elderly in California. We'd rather do this than cut another $1 billion out of public education. It's a matter of simple choices. So it's not their money. It's the public's money. And we're being asked to make a choice here. And I think that this is the fair and right choice because it does not, in fact, eliminate redevelopment, but it reduces its size. Now, with regard to the difficult and very important issues that our members and communities have talked about, let me say the following, and Senator Padilla raised this a moment ago. There's the issue of proportionate funding. The way the formula is written, it may be in Bill 2 as opposed to this bill, but allow me the freedom to just make my comments at the beginning of this debate. There are some agencies, the way that the formula is done, it's a macro formula statewide. And in fact, in some redevelopment agencies, and there may be a difference between large and small agencies, as Senator Evans has pointed out to me, that in with some agencies, the money that has to go to the schools or to the special districts by formula may leave the redevelopment agencies with nothing. So in those instances, the argument is meritorious. In fact, that, geez, you might really be eliminating without any ability to recreate. I pledge to you today as your leader that we will bring forth legislation that protects against that by doing a formula that requires some degree of proportionate funding. In other words, if there's X amount of dollars in the pot for a city and a county, that the schools don't get all of it, the special districts don't get all of it, the redevelopment agencies don't get all of it, but it is divided by appropriate percentage. So I hope that commitment provides some comfort. Number two, it may be appropriate, and this is somewhat consistent, I think, with Senator Wright's proposal, it may be appropriate to consider extending the life of some redevelopment agencies if they are meeting the public policy criteria that we choose to identify going forward, whether it's SB 375 compliance or whether it is meeting housing standards, whatever it may be, creating more jobs than not. So that may be appropriate to consider, and certainly I am very open to that. Number three, the issue of housing. And I want to commend Senator DeSonia. I don't see him on the floor here. Sure he's. I want to commend Senator DeSonia for taking the lead in working very hard to make sure that affordable housing is protected here as part of whatever we want to do. The current bills do not contain the following, but I commit today on the floor that the cleanup bill will contain the following, that reducing housing allocations must be a last resort, and that the legislation legally commit full payback of any money under-allocated to affordable housing no later than 2016. And if I didn't completely get that right, you'll excuse me, but I think I did. Four, there's an issue about treating state surplus property in a different way, because the state has interests in maximizing our assets. And I've committed to Senator Calderon that we will address that issue in the cleanup bill. And then, of course, there are the myriad of other reforms relating to the to a tighter definition of blight, around encouraging infill and jobs housing balance. And we will have the opportunity to take up those issues as well. I want to also thank Senator Wolk, who I know has taken a leadership position on all of these issues as chair of our Governance and Finance Committee. This is not perfect, but members, to fail to pass this legislation today, let me be very clear about it, would mean a $1.7 billion hole in our budget, and we will not have finished our work today. So pass the bill. And I commit to you that we will take care of these issues that I described over the last few moments. Thank you very much.
Further debate or discussion? Further debate or discussion? Senator Huff, thank you.
Thank you, Mr. President, members. We have a lot of important bills before us today. The task that we're engaged upon is important, getting a budget for the state of California. But this vote right here is the most important vote of the day. Don't be confused, because what you would do today is stop something that's been in existence for over 50 years, something that has provided economic development for local communities, something that's provided a tool, an economic tool, to create something out of nothing, to take rundown areas and build them up, to clean up brownfields that had no resources to do it, to take flood zones that were flooding out houses and businesses and to fix those. Redevelopment is not a choice of this or that, as it has been characterized. Redevelopment is something that creates more tax revenue out of what exists. And that's the fundamental premise that is being missed today in the guise of shutting it down. You shut it down, you kill it. We don't know what it's going to be reconstituted as. That's just the fact. So I appreciate the pro tem's reference to working on the stuff in the future. I don't know what that looks like. I don't know what my cities believe about that. But here's what I do know. I have all but two of my cities that have redevelopment agencies. And just as one of my other colleagues talked about the city he came from and how important redevelopment was to them, my cities have individually come to me and told me how difficult it would be for them to survive without redevelopment as an economic tool. They've told me of some of the great projects that they have done, in some cases creating freeway on-ramp and off-ramps where the state couldn't do it. And so doing, creating economic development areas that would not have existed without that. So what we end up doing then is killing this tool and replacing it with what? We don't know. So I know my cities like what we have now. They're willing to reform what we have now. But what we're being offered is a promise to reconstitute it in something that may or may not meet their needs. So if we're going to reform redevelopment, and I believe we should, then let's do it in a thoughtful process going forward, not driving a stake in the heart of redevelopment now. Because what is driving this effort to kill redevelopment? It's about the money. Isn't it always about the money? There is a belief that because of Prop 22, we can't take their money as we've done in the past, so we'll just kill it instead. And then if they voluntarily want to reconstitute themselves in some Frankenstein type of redevelopment agency, then there will be money flowing again for a redirected cause. But the state's going to score, they believe, $1.7 billion. That money's not there, folks. That money's already been siphoned off in past budgets. So it's not there, but there is a win-win situation. There has been some compromise and reforms that have been hammered out over the last 5 months. That's not before us today, but that's what we should be voting on, something that reforms redevelopment some, but then in a voluntary manner gets the state the money they need, $1.7, $2 billion. Pick a formula you want to get. We can get real money in a short period of time and score it in this budget year without punishing local government that's actually done what we've asked them to do. They've used the tools we created to create economic development. They've used tools we have enabled them to help their own communities. And what does the state do best? The things that are working, we come around and shake it all down and say, we got a better idea. I guarantee you, our local governments do not think we have a better idea. The 10 largest mayors in the state oppose this plan also. Why? Because it's bad for their communities. It's bad for all of our communities that have this, and we have no viable plan. We have a few ideas. We have no plan how to reconstitute it. Members, this is an emotional issue for many of us because we know our communities will be struggling without it. Eminent domain has been brought up. That's a phantom issue. There is very little eminent domain used in redevelopment agencies, and cities already have that, and they would retain that even without. So let's not hang it on to eminent domain. There is an unemployment rate of 12%. By killing this today, how are we helping that? I would argue that by reforming it and shaping it, we can continue to create jobs through this economic engine that we have available to us right now. Again, the money's not there. That's what's driving this. If we're going to reform it, let's do it thoughtfully and know everything that's being on the table. Talk to our local communities about it. This bill, these two bills today, do not accomplish that. I urge your no vote.
Senator Vargas.
Thank you, Mr. President. I guess I had to rise. I wasn't going to speak on this issue, but for the unique argument that, yes, it is about the money. The reality is that if we could freeze the taxes as they are today, and go forward, there's many of us, including myself, that wouldn't be voting for this bill. Because I do think that redevelopment has done a great deal of good things around the state. But the reasonable argument that we had, the looking at this in a very serious way for months and months and months, have brought us here to this point where we can't get a couple of people to go ahead and come forward and say, let's freeze the taxes as they are today. Let's save the redevelopment areas as they are today. We can't do that. I mean, the reality is that it is about the money. And if we don't pass this, we won't have a balanced budget. We won't meet our constitutional obligation, which is to pass a balanced budget today. So, yes, this is a very difficult bill. I don't like this bill. I think most of us don't. But the reality is, it is about the money. And we don't have a lot of money. We don't have enough money to fund our schools. We don't have enough money to fund our courts. We don't have enough money for the poor who need our help. And at the same time, then we say, well, we're going to keep these redevelopment agencies intact. No, it is about the money. Give us the opportunity to save this by allowing the taxes to be frozen in place. The taxes, by the way, that a Republican governor signed into law. Allow us to do that, and we won't need to do this. But we have to because there is no money. Thank you, Mr. President.
Further debate or discussion? Senator Huff, to be followed by Senator Berryhill.
Thank you, Mr. President. I'm going to ignore for the moment the path to a vote that would have gotten the tax on the ballot, and I'm going to focus on my colleague's comment about the money. You're making my point. You're counting on this helping to balance your budget, but the money is not there. It is ink on paper because the state has already taken their money. There is a path to score real money. The redevelopment agencies have polled their member cities. They have come up with $2 billion. We can get $1.7 within the first few months. That's real money. That will fill the hole you want. The other one, the plan this year before us, is about $200 to $250 million. So if you want to have $1.5 billion hole in the budget you're doing today, vote for this. If you want real money, let redevelopment survive. We have a way that we can get the money you need. This is not it.
Senator Berryhill.
Thank you, Mr. President, members. I wasn't going to speak on this bill either. I was just going to speak on the budget today, but I feel compelled. In the 14th Senate District, we suffer from anywhere from 12 to 30% unemployment. And you've heard horror stories about abuse with redevelopment. I can't talk to that, but I can talk to the 14th Senate District from Fresno to Clovis. And I can tell you definitively that in those cities, they have used this as an absolute tool to improve economic conditions and create jobs.
Senator Berryhill, one moment, please. Members, we have a colleague who's losing his voice. If we could ask for absolute quiet and attention to the member. And then, Senator Berryhill, please proceed. One moment. Please proceed, Senator.
Thank you, Mr. President. So, when it gets right down to it, this thing, one other tidbit that nobody's mentioned today is that we've mentioned about a $1.7 billion hole. We have gotten $7 billion in new money that really covers that hole as we sit here. So not only do we have the money to cover that hole, but we're creating a position that we must have here in the state, in my district. I strongly urge a no vote. Thank you.
Members, is there any additional debate or discussion? Any additional debate or discussion? Seeing and hearing none, Senator, forgive me. We have a block. There we go. Senator Lowenthal, please proceed.
Members, for all of us, including myself, this is a very difficult vote. I believe in redevelopment. Wherever you go in my district, whether it's Long Beach or Paramount or Cerritos, the southeastern cities, Lakewood, you can see the wonderful benefits of redevelopment. But as we all know, redevelopment depends upon the tax increment, which means that it's not free money. It's money that comes from, that would have been allocated to the counties or to the schools or to the cities or to special districts. It's not free. And so we're faced with this choice of how can we support schools and other vital services and at the same time protect redevelopment. I did not know how I was going to vote until I listened to the pro tem. I am now here to support this bill because he has given us assurances of three things. One, that redevelopment will not just be recreated if city or counties wish to voluntarily support it. It will not just be done on paper, but the formulas that will be provided in the cleanup bill will enable redevelopment to continue. We will not divide up the money so that there is not money for redevelopment. It'll be, that's one. Two, I think a major step is that the pro tem has said, in understanding this, we realize that extensions will be or may be necessary to allow redevelopment to exist, to be able to develop the kinds of projects. And there was a third one, there was a commitment to protect housing. So we have commitments to protect economic development, housing, and also to provide extensions if the additional resources are needed. And at the same time, not to take away the money that's when we, if and when we pass the next bill. So I do not see this. I urge my colleagues to vote yes, because I believe we will protect redevelopment by voting yes. Thank you.
Senator Hancock.
I rise in support of Senator Lowenthal's remarks. I honestly have listened to this whole debate. I did not know how I was going to vote. I have also talked with the pro tem and with many members who share very serious concerns about the future of affordable housing and about low-income communities who may have difficulty with various aspects of this piece of, these pieces of legislation. I also appreciate that we are talking about the people's money, and we're talking about our children and our schools. And I believe and have talked with Senator Steinberg that he will, in the legislation that we do, move to protect cities that may not have the revenues to make the schools whole and also to continue to run their cities, and that this we will be able to move forward. I have a commitment, too, to rebuild higher education that we cut and to move forward and make sure that that great economic engine, which I would submit is this probably just as great as redevelopment, also continues for this state. But today, as I said before, we are doing the best we can with what's in front of us. And thank you, Senator Steinberg, for your commitment to mend it, not end it.
Further debate or discussion? Further debate or discussion? Further debate or discussion? Seeing and hearing none, Senator Leno, you may close.
Thank you, Mr. President. I won't extend an already very lengthy debate, but I do want to point out that there is no constitutional requirement, there's no statutory requirement for redevelopment agencies in California. There's an authority for the state. What I'm hearing is we want to have it all, as Senator Vargas was saying. We want to fund education. We want to fund public safety. We want to lower taxes. We want redevelopment. It doesn't all add up. This is $1.7 billion worth of solution to the budget that we will pass today. I ask for your aye vote.
Mr. Secretary, please call the roll.
Ahlquist? Aye. Anderson? Berryhill? No. Blakeslee? No. Calderon? Canella? No. Corbett? Aye. Correa? De Leon? Aye. Desaunier? Dutton? Emerson? No. Evans? Aye. Fuller? No. Gaines? Aye. Hancock? Aye. Harmon? No. Hernandez? Aye. Huff? No. Kehoe? Aye. LaMalfa? No. Leno? Aye. Ted Lieu? Carol Lieu? Aye. Lowenthal? Aye. Negrete McLeod? Padilla? Pavley? Aye. Price? Rubio? Runner? Smidian? Aye. Steinberg? Aye. Strickland? No. Vargas? Aye. Walters? Wolk? Aye. Wright? No. Weiland? No. Yee? Yee, no.
Mr. Secretary, please call the absent members.
Anderson? No. Calderon? Correa? No. Desaunier? Dutton? No. Ted Lieu? Negrete McLeod? Aye. Padilla? Price? Aye. Rubio? Runner? Walters?
Mr. Secretary, please call the absent members.
Calderon? Aye. Desaunier? Ted Lieu? Padilla? Rubio? Runner? Walters?
Mr. Secretary? Please call the absent members.
Desaunier, Ted Lieu, Padilla, Rubio, Runner, Walters.
Mr. Secretary, please call the absent members.
Desaunier, Ted Lieu, Padilla, Rubio, Runner, Walters.
Mr. Secretary, please call the absent members.
Desaunier, Ted Lieu, Padilla, Rubio, Runner, Walters.
Mr. Secretary, please call the absent members.
DeSaunier. Ted Lieu. Padilla. Rubio. Runner. Walters.
Senator Steinberg requests a call. Call has been moved on file item number 5, AB 26. The measure is on call. Senator Leno. Are you prepared to take up file item 6, AB 27 in the first extraordinary session? Then we will ask the Secretary to please read.
Assembly Bill 27 by Assemblymember Blumenfeld, an act relating to redevelopment and making an appropriation therefore to take effect immediately, bill related to the budget.
Thank you, Mr. President. Colleagues, this is the bill that allows us to vote for the previous bill because it will create the alternative ongoing RDA program with reforms to which communities can opt in and continue their redevelopment programs. And again, the two bills together will be $1.7 billion of our total budget solutions. The communities that opt into this new program will continue their redevelopment, requires for community remittances to schools, fire districts, and transit districts. It provides $340 million of new funding for schools and $60 million of new funding for fire and transit districts in 2012-13 and moving forward. It most importantly fully implements and restores the housing set aside after the 11-12 budget year. It also includes very clear intent language for future legislation to which Senator Steinberg has already referred that would reduce community remittances if an RDA's projects meet statewide goals for transportation, job creation, economic development, environmental protection, and remediation. That third bill, which we will be getting to in the coming weeks, will give incentive to those RDAs to lower their contributions should they move forward with statewide goals. I ask for your aye vote.
Debate or discussion on this item, members. Debate or discussion, Senator Wright.
This is probably the second part of a discussion, but members, I would go back to an old saying that my parents used to say, that there's never enough time to do it right and there's always enough time to do it over. We've been playing with this issue now for the last 6 months. If all of the things that you've heard of reform that were going to happen, they just occurred in the last 48 hours. What have we been doing for the last 6 months? I submit to you that none of that stuff will happen because it assumes that not only do you get all of the votes, but that you have a governor who also concurs with the position. You might be able to assemble the votes here to do that, but you don't have any commitment from the person who has to sign the bill to do those things. And he didn't make a commitment to you. His initial commitment was he wanted to eliminate the program. Now, we were discussing earlier that whose money is it? When I was referring to their money, I wasn't making it a case where it was mine or that it belongs to the locals, but let me remind you of something. Just like you, I have mayors in my city, I have city council members in my city, I have supervisors in my district, I have people who were elected just like me. Perhaps unlike you, I have full faith in them that they know how to run the jurisdictions that they've been elected to, just like we have. So what we're doing here, members, is we've made a decision. We're going to balance our budget by taking the money that they've been using to balance theirs. So the discussion earlier is absolutely true. So here in Sacramento, they're going to lay off a few hundred police officers. Most of the cities and counties that you represent have been laying off workers because they have not had enough money. So our solution to them is to come and take even more of their money. Some of the cities have done something where they've been using personnel on two sides. Yes, they've used some of the RDA personnel to do some of the city work. That's not illegal. But I want to take you back to another thing. The redevelopment agencies have been complying with the law. Let me say that again. The discussion of abuse suggests that the redevelopment agencies have somehow been committing crimes. Not one redevelopment agency in California has been accused of violating a law. If it was, they should be put in jail. I wouldn't have a quarrel with that. They have been complying with the law. Even if you take the issue of the school money that has to be paid back, that occurred in Prop 98. It wasn't a defect in the redevelopment law. That was a change in law that occurred subsequent to redevelopment agencies. So here we're saying to the redevelopment agency, if you don't give me all the money that I want, I'm going to shut you down. Now, in South Central LA, we call that extortion. Now, I'm not sure what you call it in Sacramento, but in South Central, that's extortion. If you don't give me your money, then I shoot you in the head. That's extortion, plain and simple. That's why much of what will happen in this bill will be litigated. That's why you're not going to get any money in the budget year. That's why I would suggest that if we're concerned about redevelopment, if all of the things that have been described are possible, then what we should do is recess and go do those things now, so that what we send is exactly what we intend. So we're not in the position of hoping that whether it's the assembly or the governor or whomever else concurs with the position that we have. I, like many of you, have the utmost appreciation and respect for the pro tem. I don't have that same confidence in the other branches of government that would have to concur with what we do. And the only way that you have that you're going to maintain control is if you only send something that you're prepared to live with. If you send something that you can't live with under the guise that I'll fix it later, then you just bought a pig in a poke. And you ain't gonna fix nothing later, because that assumes that the other people will let you fix it later, and you don't have any control over that. So again, if you're voting for these two bills today, you're voting to eliminate redevelopment. It ain't a reform. There ain't gonna be no housing. There ain't gonna be any economic development, because if there was, you'd leave it alone. Today is a vote to eliminate flat, plain and simple redevelopment. It's a vote to take money from local governments that they control to do the development that we'd want done.
Senator Wright, one moment, please. Members. One moment, please, Senator Wright. Senator Wright, thank you for your patience. Please proceed.
Okay. This is a vote to eliminate an agency. Will you be able to restore it? Maybe. Can you control the restoration? No. You are now voting to kill something and then hope that later on it's within your power to resurrect it. I submit to you that if you really believe that, then fix it today. That's what we should do. That's why you should vote no on AB 27. Because if you really believe in redevelopment, if you really believe in the local elected officials with whom you share public service, then you need to become public servants and serve. And the way you do that is you work cooperative with the people who also represent constituencies just like you do. This is a taking of their revenue. You'll spend the next year in court. There'll be no money in the budget year. I ask for a no vote.
Senator Harmon.
I had a question for the floor manager, if I could, please.
Senator Leno, are you prepared to take a question? Senator Harmon, please proceed.
Thank you very much. Senator Leno, can you tell me, does this measure include the provision sought by Speaker Perez that would overturn a court settlement agreement in order to allow the Los Angeles Redevelopment Agency to continue to issue more debt? That was something he put in this bill over in the Assembly and got special treatment for Los Angeles. Is that still in the bill?
It's a very good question, Senator Harmon. To the best of my knowledge, that has been amended out.
It is out.
It is out.
Good, good.
And that set us. And Senator Harmon, the carve out that our colleague from Los Angeles claimed there was for San Francisco, that's out too, because it was never in.
Further debate or discussion, Senator Emerson.
Thank you, Mr. President and members. Wildfires in California are a huge problem, and we all know that. The Riverside County Redevelopment Agency is going to build a new facility for CAL FIRE. They're going to extend a runway, realign a highway, and build a new facility for air tankers to fight wildfires in California. The reason the Riverside County RDA is doing that is California doesn't have the money to do it. And Riverside County RDA is going to do that right away. This is, as Senator Wright says, this is killing the RDA. This is not in any way going to extend or create a situation where these types of programs can be completed. California needs the air tanker base. They need it now. They needed it several years ago, but California couldn't afford to build it. I ask for a no vote on this measure.
Further debate or discussion? Seeing and hearing none, Senator Leno, you may close.
Colleagues, ask for your aye vote.
Mr. Secretary, please call the roll.
Ahlquist?
Aye.
Anderson?
No.
Berryhill?
No.
Blakeslee?
No.
Calderon? Canella?
No.
Corbett?
Aye.
Correa?
No.
De Leon?
Aye.
Desaunier? Dutton?
No.
Emerson?
No.
Evans?
Aye.
Fuller?
No.
Gaines?
Aye.
Hancock? Harmon?
No.
Hernandez?
Aye.
Huff?
No.
Kehoe?
Aye.
LaMalfa?
No.
Leno?
Aye.
Ted Lieu? Carol Lieu? Aye. Lowenthal?
Aye.
Negrete McLeod?
Aye.
Padilla? Pavley?
Aye.
Price?
Aye.
Rubio? Runner? Somidian?
Aye.
Aye. Steinberg?
Aye.
Strickland?
Yeah.
No. Vargas?
Aye.
Walters?
No.
Wolk?
Aye.
Wright?
No.
Weiland?
No.
Yee?
Yee,
no.
Call the absent members.
Calderon?
Aye.
Desaunier? Hancock?
Aye.
Ted Lieu? Padilla? Rubio? Runner?
Senator Steinberg moves a call. Members, one moment, please, while I confer with the Secretary of the Senate. I believe that completes for the moment our work in the extraordinary session. Then, if there is no further business for the moment in the first extraordinary session, then at this time, the first extraordinary session will stand in recess, and the regular session will be reconvened. Members, second supplemental file. On the Senate supplemental file number 2, it is file item 75. Mr. Secretary, please read.
Senate Bill 85 by the Committee on Budget and Fiscal Review and Act relating to Education Finance, making an appropriation therefore to take effect immediately, bill related to the budget.
Senator Leno, are you prepared to take up this item? Please proceed. Members, one moment, please, if I could have your attention. Members, could I have your attention, please? We have recessed the first extraordinary session. We are back in regular session. This is file item 75 on our regular session, supplemental file number 2. The Secretary has read. Senator Leno will now present.
Thank you, colleagues. We are concurring on assembly amendments, which include the elimination of $3 billion in Prop 98 ongoing and one-time settlement, settle-up funds, utilizes surplus County Office of Education property balances, tax balances that are currently restricted to offset other programs, reducing state general fund costs by up to $50 million. There's also the deferral of the University of California to move June 2012 general fund allocation to August 2012 and additionally amends the community college deferral back to where we were in March to the level of $961 million. I ask for your aye vote.
Debate or discussion? Senator Fuller.
Mr. Chair, I just liked, we've had a history lesson today, so now I think it's appropriate that we do a little math in regards to this issue. In the January budget, we funded at $49.3 billion, and that was with the ballot taxes proposition. Today, the budget funding is $49.7 billion without the ballot taxes. If you do the math, we've actually increased the funding by about $4 million to K-14, $400 million. But then this budget really underfunds that by $1 billion. So we actually have created more debt, more budgetary debt. We haven't really helped anyone in education in the current year. So I urge a no vote.
Further debate or discussion? Seeing and hearing none, Senator Leno, you may close.
Thank you, Mr. President. Clearly, changes to the education bill I would prefer we not have to make, and many others in this room would prefer not to have to make, but without the freezing of current tax rates, something we have to do to balance our budget, I ask for your aye vote.
Mr. Secretary, please call the roll.
Ahlquist?
Aye.
Aye. Anderson? No. Berryhill? No. Blakeslee? No. Calderon? Aye. Cannella? No. Corbett? Aye. Correa? No. De Leon? DeSaunier? Dutton? No. Emerson? No. Evans? Aye. Fuller? No. Gaines? No. Hancock? Aye. Harmon? No. Hernandez? Aye. Huff? No. Kehoe? Aye. LaMalfa? No. Leno? Aye. Ted Lieu? Aye. Carol Lieu? Aye. Lowenthal? Aye. Negrete McLeod? Aye. Padilla? Aye. Pavley? Aye. Price? Aye. Rubio? Runner? Smidian? Aye. Steinberg? Aye. Strickland? No. Vargas? Aye. Walters? No. Wolk? Aye. Wright? Weiland? No. Yee? Yee, no.
Mr. Secretary, call the absent members.
De Leon? DeSaunier? Rubio? Runner? Wright?
Mr. Secretary, please call the absent members.
De Leon? DeSaunier, Rubio, Runner, Wright. Wright, aye.
Mr. Secretary, please call the absent members.
De Leon, De Leon, aye. DeSaunier, Rubio, Runner.
Mr. Secretary, for the last time, please call the absent members.
DeSaunier, Rubio, Runner.
Senator Steinberg. Senator Steinberg moves a call. Senator Steinberg, at this time, we have completed the business of the Senate on the regular session file. We have one item that remains on call. On the first extraordinary session file, we have two items that remain on call. With the exception of the items that remain on call, I believe we have completed the business of the day. How would you like to proceed at this time?
Thank you very much, Mr. President. Let us take a 20-minute recess till 3:05, and hopefully at that time we'll get the members back, and we will finish our work on the 2011-12 budget. Thank you.
Thank you, Senator Steinmeier. One moment, please, members. We do have an announcement. Because of the progression of budget bills today and the business remaining in the Assembly, today's committees scheduled will be canceled with the agreement of the chair. The Rules Committee will work to reschedule. One moment, please, while we clarify with the Secretary of the Senate. We are speaking of Senate committees, including the Senate Committee on Education, which met earlier today, as well as the Committee on Government and Finance, as well as the Senate Banking Committee, as well as the Senate Health Committee. By virtue, again, of the progress of budget bills today, as well as the business that remains in the Assembly, those committees scheduled will be canceled with the agreements of the chair, and the Rules Committee will work to reschedule. Members, we stand in recess until 3:05.